وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَّبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتُ وَالْأَرْضُ أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ وسيق الذين كفروا إلى جهنم زمرا حتى إذا جاءوها فتحت أبوابها وقال لهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم رسل من يتلون عليكم آيات ربكم وينذرونكم لقاء يومكم هذا قالوا بلى ولكن حقت كلمة العذاب على الكافرين
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته Sayyidatina Aisha radiallahu anha says in this narration, narrated by the Imams of Hadith, among them Al-Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, لَوْ أَنَّ أَوَّلَ مَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ لَا تَشْرَبُ الْخَمْرَ لَقَالَ النَّاسُ لَا وَاللَّهِ لَا نَتْرُكُ الْخَمْرَ أَبَدًا وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَوَّلَ مَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ لَا تَزْنُ لقال الناس لا والله لا نترك الزنا أبدا ولكن كان أول ما نزل من القرآن سور مفصل فيها ذكر الجنة والنار حتى ثابت القلوب إلى ربها ثم نزل الحلال والحرام This is a very important statement by سيدتنا عائشة رضي الله عنها and it gives us an analysis of the human heart and how to deal with it. The question of how can I improve my iman is a question every sincere Muslim is concerned about. Everyone wants to raise their iman. Everyone wants to be a good Muslim. But we become weak. We want to be better than we are. But we fall short. And we always ask the question, how can I strengthen my iman? Aisha radiallahu anha in this statement gives us a clue of how to deal with the illness of weak iman. Aisha radiallahu anha, first of all, I'll translate the statement and then comment on it. Aisha radiallahu anha says, لو أن أول ما نزل من القرآن لا تشرب الخمر لقال الناس لا والله لا نترك الخمر أبدا. If the first command revealed in the Quran, the first ayat revealed in the Quran, we're telling the people to stop drinking alcohol, people would have said no. In the name of Allah, we're not going to stop drinking. ولو أن أول ما نزل من القرآن لا تزنوا لقال الناس لا والله لا نترك الزنا أبدا. And if the first command revealed in Qur'an was stop fornication, stop adultery, people would have said no, in the name of Allah, we're never going to stop fornication and we're never going to stop adultery. وَلَكِنْ كَانَ أَوَّلَ مَا نَزَلَ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ سُوَرَ الْمُفَصَّلْ فِيهَا ذِكْرُ الْجَنَّةِ وَالنَّارِ But the first ayat revealed in Qur'an, where the surah of Mufassal, and surah of Mufassal are the last surah of Qur'an which were revealed in Mecca. According to the Mus'haf, the last surah were revealed in Mecca. So she says, these were the first surah revealed in Qur'an. فِيهَا ذِكْرُ الْجَنَّةِ وَالنَّارِ In these surah, is the mention of Jannah, Paradise, and Nar, Hellfire. حَتَّى ثَابَتِ الْقُلُوبُ إِلَى رَبِّهَا Until the hearts went back to their Lord. ثم نزل الحلال والحرام. And then the حلال and حرام, the do and don't, was revealed. What does this mean? Sayyidatina Aisha رضي الله عنها is telling us her analysis of the human heart and her analysis of Iman and how to strengthen it. She says, if the first verses revealed to the new Muslims who just became Muslim in Mecca were stop drinking, stop zina, people, because of their attachment to these sins, would have refused. Why? Because their Iman is weak. Yes, they may believe in Allah. Yes, they may believe that Muhammad is Rasulullah, but they are not yet ready for sacrifice and for giving up the entrenched traditions, norms, or habits. Because this needs sacrifice. It needs willingness to give for Allah Azza wa Jalla. And this was not there yet. This is something that needs to be built up. And how is that built up? Sayyidatina Aisha radiallahu anha said, it was through the ayat of Qur'an. And what were these ayat of Qur'an talking about? They were talking about Jannah and Nar. The constant reminder of paradise and hell would cure the good heart. The evil heart, nothing may work with it. وَيَّرَوْ كُلَّ آيَةٍ لَا يُؤْمِنُ بِهَا. Allah Azza wa Jalla says about them, if they see every sign, they're not going to believe. This is in reference to the people of Fir'aun. Allah Azza wa Jalla has sent them sign after sign after sign. If there was any goodness in their hearts, these signs would have changed them. But because the heart is upside down, it's evil, nothing works with it. But the good heart, the ayat of Allah Azza wa Jalla would give it reminder. وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Remind, because reminder benefits who? Allah Azza wa Jalla says it benefits the believers. It doesn't benefit the one who does not have belief in his heart. It benefits who? The believers. So this constant reminder of Jannah and Nar is the cure, is the answer for your question. How can I increase and strengthen my Iman? Think about Jannah. Think about Nar. And don't restrict yourself. I mean, just think about it. Don't worry. You're not going to be committing anything haram by thinking about how good Jannah is or how bad Nar is. Even if your imagination turned out wrong, don't worry. That's not a sin. Because you may think that I'm going to have to stick with what was mentioned about Jannah and what was mentioned about Nar, and since I don't know that, then I'm not going to think about them. No. Don't worry. If you want to think about what interests you is being in Jannah, even though it's not mentioned in the Qur'an, no problem. Think about it. Because, again, if it's wrong, as long as you're not saying that this does exist in Jannah for sure, that shouldn't be a problem. Because remember, again, that in Jannah you can ask for anything you want. So even if this thing that you want, for example, a particular type of food or a particular candy or chocolate, didn't exist in the time of Rasulullah ﷺ, yes, it's not going to be mentioned in Sunnah or mentioned in Quran. But you want to have it in